God has set you in heavenly places with his Son. You have as much right to be in heavenly places as Christ if you belong to him. Praise God. We are seated in heavenly places with him. We are in him, praise God. Amen. He is high and lifted up. He's given us his children. That's why we call him Abba, Father. You'll go and inherit all things, praise God. There ought not be nothing in this world that makes you depressed or makes you feel like you're left out. But if you're one of his children, if you can cry, Abba, Father, that if you confessed his name with your lip and you believed in your heart that God raised the Son from the dead, praise God. Amen. You are seated in heavenly places with him. You are high and lifted up, praise God. Amen. And for that reason, we confess his name. Look with me in the book of Hebrews. Let me just bring you to where you at and bring you where I'm at tonight in my mind and my spirit through the Word of God. And I just want you to see this. My heart is just busting tonight with the fact that those of you here tonight, you come out this cold. You come here tonight to hear the Word of God. You come to worship the Word of God. You come here to be encouraged and to feed on the gospel. And praise God, you're in the best place that you could ever be. Cold getting in and out of the house, getting into the car, getting into the church. But you in the Word of God, it's better than any place you could be on planet Earth. Amen. There's nowhere better than being in the Word of God on the anointing of his Word. Now look with me in Hebrews 1:4. He, Christ, look at this scripture. Being made better. Now you got to look at this. If you don't see it, you won't get it. Ask the Holy Spirit to put it in your spirit. Look at verse 4. Same thing we're talking about now. Verse 4, chapter 1, Hebrews. Being made so much better than what? The angels. Him. As he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. His name is high and lifted up. His name is much more better than Michael's or Gabriel's. His name is better than any angel. His name is high, and he's obtained a better and a more excellent way, our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, this morning I was sharing with you that every name shall bow universally, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess things in heaven, things in earth, and things under the earth. Now, I want to take you to Revelation chapter 5. This morning we were talking about, and I was sharing with you this morning, the fact that if it's not a matter of when you confess him as Lord, you will one day. When you will one day confess the Lord Jesus Christ, but the big issue that men have to deal with, and you're going to have to deal with, everybody's got to deal with this, is where you confess Jesus with your mouth. It's where you confess Jesus with your mouth. If you don't confess Jesus with your mouth in this world and you miss him, and when you get there, it'll be too late. You will confess him as Lord, but you'll spend eternity outside of him. You'll miss it. You have to confess him as Lord in this world to obtain salvation. That's the message. That's what the church is about. That's the gospel message. If we don't preach that, we need to put a sign out there, and God will. Maranatha, the Spirit of the Lord is departed. If we don't preach Christ, we miss it. Amen. It's not about religion. It's not about coming to church, set times, set things, and all these things. That's good. That's great. That's grand. But if we don't confess him as Lord, and he's not amongst us, and he's not walking in our midst, we might as well close the door and get out of the business. It's about him. The power is in the name of the Lord. His name is better and higher than any angel. Amen. His power, he's exalted. He's far above and high and lifted up. Look with me in Revelation, if you would. Revelation chapter 5, verse 13. Let's look there. In all of heaven, there was not one man that was able to open the seals. None. There was nothing. There was no one. People wept. They looked for someone to open up the seals so that God could judge the earth and bring in judgment and bring the thing to pass to save fallen men. chapter 5, verse 4, but I wept much. Look with me in Revelation 5, 4. But I wept much because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. But, verse 5, and one of the elders said unto me, weep not. Don't weep. There's one. Don't weep. There's one. But behold, the Lion, the tribe of Judah, the root of David, hath prevailed and opened the book and to loose the seals, the seven seals thereof. Now look with me in verse 13. And every creature, now look and think about this a minute. There's only one man that was worthy. Him. His name is high and lifted up. He come to this earth, fashioned himself as a man, walked this earth, born of a woman, walked in humanity. He walked at every jot and tittle of the law. He become prophet, priest, and king. He fulfilled all the offices of the Old Testament. He fulfilled everything the Father sent him to do. He died on the cross, suffered on the cross, shed his immaculate blood. George Washington praying out there, and before he would go into battle, they would hear him pray. He would ask God to bless him in the immaculate blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. We know as Christians today that there was a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins. Praise God. Amen. That's why we sing those songs. He shed his blood, redeemed us. He's worthy tonight. Verse 13, and every creature, look very close at this, and every creature which is in heaven and in earth and under the earth, every creature, and such are as in the sea, and all that are in them, heard I saying, blessed and honor and glory and power be unto him. Everything, every creature in the sea, on the throne, and him that sitteth on the throne, unto the Lamb forever and ever, blessed and honor and glory and power be unto who? Him. Amen. Every creature shall confess his name. Where? On the earth. The demons under the earth will say, it's blessed is the Lord. Every soul in the sea will rise up and say, blessed is the Lord. Today, friends, the popular ideal today is don't mention Christ, don't pray in the name of Jesus. You offend the Muslims, you offend the Islams, you offend the Jewish people. Let them be offended. Amen. Pray in his name. Amen. You confess him here, he'll confess you there. Amen. Mushy mouth preachers today not preaching anything, better preach Christ. If you don't preach Christ, you'll leave people with no hope. It's him that we praise tonight. What will it? It's the Lord Jesus. No other name. His name is high and lifted up. Revelation chapter 7, if you would, 9 through 12. Look at the scripture. And this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man can number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before what? The throne. Are y'all getting with me tonight? The whole world, put it in popular language, every man on planet Earth, every tribe, the Chinese, the Jews, Spain, Italy, Germans, every tribe on planet Earth, look, his name lifted up. Look at this. You just got to see this. And tongues stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hand, and cried with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our God which sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb. And all, not a few of them, but how many? All the angels stood round about the throne, about the elders, the four beasts, and fell before the throne on their faces and did what? And worship God. We sitting high and lifted up and satisfied with our little religion that we got. I want to tell y'all what tonight. We ought to be worshiping God tonight. We ought to be saying, praise God. Thank you, Lord. You need to get used to it because you're going to feel out of place when you get there and you don't worship him now. Well, folks might think something's wrong with me if I say praise God. Let me tell you, one day you'll stand there and you'll praise Him.